Hi, I'm Dr. Patrick Foy. I'm an MD or medical doctor, and I'm the director of the Coccyx Pain Center or Tailbone Pain Center online at www.tailbonedoctor.com. And in this short video, I'm just going to talk a couple of minutes about different types of cushions that people use for tailbone pain. So there's lots of different cushions that are available. I've done an earlier video on this as well, but in this one, I'm just gonna kind of update to show a couple of different types of wedge cushions. So unlike donut cushions, which have a hole in the middle, those are typically not so great for most people with tailbone pain. Most people do better with what's called a wedge cushion, where it has a cutout in the back. The idea of that the cutout in the back is that the tailbone sort of hovers over that cutout so that the tailbone does not make contact with the chair that you're sitting on. So if this is the cushion here, I'll set it up here so that the cushion is closest to you, the viewer. And if this was somebody who's sitting, you know, facing that way, they're basically sitting like this, you know, so that you can see that the tailbone or coccyx is kind of hovering over the hole here. So that it doesn't make contact with the chair and then the person doesn't have as much pain. So it's called a wedge cushion because it has that cutout or wedge. Sometimes it's triangle shaped or U-shaped like this. It also has a wedge because you can see from the side view, it has kind of a slope to it. And what that slope does is that while you're sitting, it keeps you into a little bit of forward flexion, which also brings the tailbone forward so it's not leaning back, which is typically, you know, would be worse for the tailbone. So that's a typical wedge cushion. A lot of times it will have a handle like this to make it, you know, relatively convenient for you to just carry along. So that's a wedge cushion, you know, example number one. Another one that I'll show, and that one happens to be car cush. This is a different one here. This one is Adiano. And this one is actually a memory foam cushion, because one of the problems sometimes with the cushions is that sometimes when you get them, they seem fine. But then, you know, if they're too firm, then they're going to cause other problems and pain at the areas that are taking pressure. But if they're too soft, or if the firmness, you know, fades over time, then it flattens out. This one is still relatively new, but sometimes they may flatten out. And then it gets too thin, and then it's not lifting the tailbone up, and then, you know, it's not really working or doing its function. So then what can be done is, you know, instead to use, you know, a memory foam cushion or a cushion that's more firm. This one happens to be a memory foam cushion. Again, you can see that it has that, you know, wedge shape or cutout, and the idea there is that, again, that the you know, coccyx or tailbone, you know, sort of hovers, you know, over the area where the hole is, so that, you know, so that your other sit bones, which are basically, let me see if I can get the angle looking okay, your sit bones here, your ischial bones, are bearing the weight when you're sitting down, but not bearing the weight at the coccyx. So this is another example of a wedge cushion. Again, this one has a handle, it's just on the side, so again, makes it convenient to hold and carry. This one, in addition to the cutout here, you can see that there is, if you look here, there's a little bit of a bump up in the front. So that can provide some additional support in the front, you know, so that can be helpful for some patients as well. Other patients may actually want there to be, you know, not even a flat surface there in the front, which would be something more like this. So here you can see now that this is, you know, giving you space, you know, to sit on both sides, you know, so basically you'd be, you know, kind of straddling these two areas. How far you or apart you want them, you can adjust, because this is Velcro, and basically when you use that Velcro, you can move these a little bit closer if you're somebody who has a more narrow pelvis, or you can move them a little farther apart if you have a wider pelvis. This particular cushion, I would say, is not necessary for the majority of patients with tailbone pain. However, if you're someone who has tailbone pain, so you don't want the pressure at the back, at where your tailbone is, but you also don't want any pressure up in the front, let's say if you're a male patient and you're having you know, pain at the scrotum or testicular area, or if you have perineal pain, which is kind of that area from the anus up front to the external genitalia in males or females. If that area is painful and sensitive, or if you're a female patient who has pain in the external genitalia that's worse with pressure in that area, then a cushion like this may be helpful because it takes the pressure off of that area as well. Again, this is, you know, I would say it's less than 5% of my patients with tailbone pain that would need or want a cushion like this. But for that subgroup, this can be very, very helpful. This one happens to be, let me find the name for you, and again, has a handle, and this one is called Cushion Your Assets. So Cushion Your Assets, if that'll focus there. And the thing about this, not only is it actually has two handles, because you can actually fold it up like this, you know, and it almost looks like a small purse, or reminds me kind of the old-fashioned doctor's bag. So that's an option as well. But again, not for the majority of patients. You know, most people would do fine, you know, or better, you know, with a regular, you know, standard cutout in the back only, you know, where you have the coccyx there, you know. So anyway, all right, so that is, so that's the scoop in terms of a couple of different types of wedge cushions specifically used for people with tailbone pain. Hope that information is helpful for you. You can get more information on tailbone pain at my website, www.tailbonedoctor.com, or you can get my book on Amazon, which is Tailbone Pain Relief Now. It's available in ebook and print book and all of that kind of thing. So anyway, hope that's helpful for you. And I will see you soon. Bye-bye.